ótima na empresa tradicionalista. Só precisamos de economia do nosso clima. Process implementation and outcomes. The case of NASO, Yasotan Problem Thailand. His Majesty King Bhumibol Adulyadej, philosophy of sufficiency economy lie at the heart of Thailand development and indeed it serves as a guide for the country's economic and social development. His Majesty clearly explained the sufficiency economy philosophy and expounded the statement of the philosophy as sufficiency economy is a philosophy that straddles the middle path. This applies to conduct at the individual level, family level, community level, and nation level. Sufficiency has three components such as moderation, reasonableness, and self-immunity. The sufficiency economy philosophy emphasizes the two conditions, which are knowledge condition and it is a moral condition. This will result in balance, stability, and sustainability of the economy, society, environment, and culture. In NASO sub-district in Kuchum district, Yasothang province has been exhibited self-reliant by launching a village cooperative store project in the village under the leadership of the former village head in Sokongkun village. When the village cooperative store was successful, other projects were such as organic rice production and organic rice fertilizer production. The ultimate aim of the study was to describe and determine the process, implementation, and outcomes of sufficiency economy philosophy in NASO sub-district, Kuchum district, Yasothang province, Thailand. The scope and limitation of the study. This research describe and determine the process, implementation, and outcomes based on the sufficiency economy philosophy. The result of the study were based on the three villages, such as NASO village, Sokongkun village, and Santisuk village. The role, capacity, and interest of the different stakeholders in project implementation will also determine. This research also includes the benefit derived from participating in the project guided by the sufficiency economy philosophy in terms of social, economic, cultural, and environmental indicators. In the methodology, this research was guided by the sufficiency economy philosophy and the stakeholder theory. The sufficiency economy philosophy emphasize the two conditions under which the philosophy will work best. First, if it is based on the application of appropriate knowledge, and second, if it is enhanced by ethics or moral value, and it decide to help with others, especially those less privileged and then ourselves. This is the stakeholder theory. Identify and model student group which are stakeholders of an organization and describe and recommend method by which management can it deal with regard to the interest of those groups. The stakeholder theory examines the individual preference and attempt to satisfy as many of those preferences as possible, with the understanding that this individual and the group they form have particular relationships with the organization and each other. In the conceptual framework of the study, this research describes the characteristics of the community, people, and other stakeholders in terms of role, capacity, and interest, and determine the process, implementation, and outcome based on the sufficiency economy philosophy. In the result of and discussion, there were 10 villages, 10 projects established by the people in the community and government agency since 1980 to 2004. I would like to introduce you about the 10 branches. Start with the village cooperative store. Established in 1980, in the town of Tani there were 426 members. Its stakeholders were village with the Nation Conservation Organization, village from Sokompun village, cooperative officer and cooperative member. This project, they have a meeting every month for a committee and election for the committee also. And they conduct the seminar on co-op management. They also provide loan for the member. And they sell the product of the member also. Next is organic rice production project. This project was established by the Nature Conservation Organization in 1991 with a member that the present is 226 members. The stakeholder in this project is village with the nature of Nature Conservation Organization, agriculturist, villager from Sokompun village, and member of the project. This project they has a meeting every 2 months, and they conduct a seminar also. And they also provide the organic rice. And they have two rice meal, and they pack the organic rice and sell to other countries also. Next is organic fertilizer production. This project is support the organic rice production project established in 1995. Now they have 250 members. The stakeholder for the Nature Conservation Organization, village needs agriculturists and the member of the project. This project they provide loan to the member. This project they produce the organic fertilizer, and they conduct a meeting, even the seminar about the how to make the organic fertilizer. Next is poverty reduction project. Is established in 1997 with 87 household members. The stakeholders were the Bank of Agriculture and Agricultural Corporation, and the committee, the development department, freelancers, and members of the project. The activity that they have is provide loan to the member, collect the loan repayment from the member, conduct meeting once a month. Next is soybean meal making project, established by women group in 1997 with 150 members. The stakeholder were public health center, public health office, Tomboy Administration Organization, Women Group, and the Village Team. This project, the Women Group produced soybean milk and rice milk. They sell the milk to the villager. Next is saving project, established by the Bank of Agriculture and Agricultural Cooperative in 2001. There are 121 members. The stakeholder were the Bank of Agriculture and Agricultural Cooperative and the Community Development Department, relationship and member of the project. The activity of this project is provide saving service about 120 baht per year and provide loan service to the member. The next project is Village and Urban Community Fund project, established in 2001. There were 130 members. The stakeholder were Community Development Department, the Bank of Agriculture and Agricultural Cooperative, Relations and the Member of the Project. They provide loan to the member also and collect payment from the member. Next is dishwashing detergent making project. This is established in 2003 by the Nature Conservation Organization with 150 members. The stakeholder were Nature Conservation Organization and Women Group. The member of the group, they produce the dishwashing detergent to use in the family to reduce the expenditure. And next is the potential development of villages and urban communities through sufficiency economy philosophy established in 2003 by the Bank of Agriculture and Agricultural Cooperative and the Community Development Department with 30 members. The stakeholder were the Bank of Agriculture and Agricultural Cooperative, Community Development Department, Relationship, and the member of the project. The activity in this project is they have provide loan service and collect the loan repayment from the member. The last one is Sea Center project. Established in 2004 with 100 members. The stakeholder were the Tamil Administration Organization, Agriculture Village, and member of the project. The activity for this project is building the nursery houses for the collected forestry and the provide the information about the objective management and cooperation of the project to the member and build a network with other C-Center projects in Nassau Southeast. And this the benefit derived from the team project. In terms of economy, they will improve household income, available market, save money and got welfare fund, reduce family expenditure, build a village hall. In terms of social, they can got involved in planning community project, participate in community project, and help each other solving the problem. And in terms of cultural, they have active participation in social cultural activities, strengthen relationship among community members, develop self-reliance by reducing extravagance. In terms of political, they can support of the village and the Tambon administration organization, increase the awareness regarding community projects, creation of organization. In terms of environmental, they can produce organic fertilizer by using farmers cutting trees when they are mature and plant more trees. Maintain a place for garbage disposal within the yard or farm. And the conclusion and recommendations. The result of the study clearly show that the advocacy, promotion, and implementation of rural development projects in the rural community, guided by the sufficiency economy philosophy, are appropriate, highly doable, realistic, and answer the problem and need of the household member as well as those of the communities. In this, sufficiency economy philosophy can be promoted in the rural villages in Thailand. For the recommendation, there can be creation of the of a management board in the village project, where regulations of the project are formulated, improved and implemented by the village member. The different stakeholders, particularly Thai regional agency, must work together and use the integrated development approach. Each stakeholder should have the capacity to provide the technical, managerial, financial, marketing information to the village people. Cash capital as loan to poor people is a major intervention or support to start small and micro enterprise. Documentation and consolidation of food management approach and strategies must be done. Next is activity toward the practice of moderation and self-immunity must be given strong emphasis, and there must be continuous activity to change people's mind or knowledge, coupled with ethics or value, guided by the middle class and further on individual community projects. Condition can be done for household and community. I have acknowledgement to the Dr. Pastora S. Koluma, my advisor and chair of the advisory committee. Dr. Theodora Chibata, Dr. Faye L. Pachinkula, Dr. Eugenia G. Balthasa, and Dr. Jocelyn L. Avenu, the member of advisory committee, Dr. Maria Excelsis M. Odin, the chairperson examining committee, Dr. Danilo Esquatas, membro do SMB Committee. Essa é a professora Lucila Slasson, English editor. E isso é a medicina, Dr. Edita City Hall, and order of official concern. And assistant professor Dr. Bakabong also. From Kimuput Institute of Technology, Lakabang, Bangkok, Thailand. Thank you.
Clarifications regarding the presentation. Yes, sir. Kindly use the microphone, state your name and the institution you are affiliated with. Thank you.
Good afternoon. I'm Dal Samsudewa, I'm from Indonesia, I'm Siaka Scholar, and I'm now studying animal science, major in animal science, and minor in wildlife studies. Actually, I'm really, the first time I read the title of your research is really, really want to know about the social, about the sufficiency economic philosophy, but actually, I cannot get the point about this, about the sufficiency economy philosophy in there, because in my thinking about sufficiency economy philosophy, it's like when traveling over a country, even they are not rich, but they feel that I'm enough like this. So that's I think that it will be. I learned from this presentation, but actually it's really different than what did I think. Connecting with your presentation, I want to ask some question to you. The first is about the organic rice production. I want to know if we compare result of the organic rice production between organic rice production and non-organic rice production. Can you have did you have a data about the result when the Naso sub-district apply the organic production, organic rice production, is it good good result in production or not? That's my first question. The next question is about the loan loan program. Actually, I want to say to that my country in Indonesia, actually some of the departments of some of the ministries always give a loan to some people, to some sub-district. But the big problem in my country, sometimes the ministry, as we know, that Indonesia actually the second biggest corruption in the world. It's, that's I know, and it's really happened in Indonesia. That's why this is my generation responsibility to make the better government. So in my country, actually, when they give me a loan to the some sub-district. The ministry is choose the one who have siblings there. If they have siblings or friends, they will try to give the loan to that place. So what happened? Like in my major about animal science, when they give people with the chicken, they give a loan for chicken, they give loan for goat, they give loan for cow. In the first month, second month, it's no problem. But when you go there, in the third month, all of this go out. Nothing is getting there. So how about your project? Is it happen like that or nothing? If nothing is good, good news for you. And the last question is, what's the entrepreneur result that resulting from all of the project? I mean that like dishwashing detergent production project. So is it resulting to the some small entrepreneur people to improve the money that they get or nothing. Oh, I'm sorry, I still left one again. But you have never explained about the knowledge and education improvement. But I think that's the important thing when we see in one project. If we only give and the result is social, economic, only that one, it will be really easy to lose. But if you get the knowledge and education increases, it will be better. Thank you.
More questions in a row is quite overwhelming. Okay, let me recap. The first question is about the rice, right? The organic versus the non-organic one, the yield. And then the second one is about the loan disbursements. He said that in Indonesia, people at the ministry choose which area to give the loans to. If they have siblings there, then they get the loans. And then the third one is the small enterprises, right? And then the fourth one is about knowledge. The knowledge and education in the areas where the projects are being given.
I may not cover all your questions, but I will give you an answer. About the organic rice, the price of the organic rice and the non-organic rice is different. Because now we would like to eat organic. Everything is organic, even the vegetable and the rice. At first, when we apply from non-organic rice to organic rice, it's not really more yield, but they try to do it. And then after that, they change from the non-organic rice because the health of the villager or the farmer in that village are very poor. They always get sick from the chemicals. So they try to reduce the chemical. That's why they have to. They would like to produce the organic rice. Now the project is going on, and they can sell export to the other country like Japan. Actually, it was the Japanese who introduced the organic rice to this village, and they also export to the European country also. And then the loan, for the loan project, it's based on this subject, the philosophy. The people are honest to return the loan, and the relations and the bank, the cooperative bank, work together. They really have a meeting every once a month, and they have one person from the bank to collect the loan. If the one who got loan cannot pay, they will not allow that person to get another loan like this. This is the loan. And next is the small enterprise. May I have this question about the small enterprise?
If the projects were able to develop the small enterprises in the area, and in terms of money, if the money within the enterprises, if they gain some profits, is that correct? If they gain some profits in their enterprises?
Yes. Like the soybean milk, they can produce milk and sell to the other villages. About 9 villages, they can sell to the villager in the 9 villages. And they have, after sale, they have saved money, about 1,000. And they can buy the material and produce again. And the fourth question
is the knowledge of education. If the education in the area improves, especially for the children,
Yes, I have data on this, but I cannot present now because it's limit of the time. But is when this result of the study is, I found that they can in the this village some can study even PhD on the some literature employed as a doctor attention.
Thank you for the interesting presentation. Now we have a publication on sufficiency economy because that was the second DL Umaru lecture by a Thai awardee, Dr. Charan Chandranana. But anyway, I'm curious about, you mentioned in your recommendations that there should be activities on self-moderation, to encourage self-moderation and self-immunity. So my first question is, what exactly is self-immunity? And second is, what are the activities to illustrate, you know, to encourage self-moderation and self-immunity in these projects?
Moderation and immunity. Moderation is like you live within your own income. Yes. Do not spend more than whatever.
What you need.
Even you get a loan, you have to increase your income also based on your loan that you get. Self-immunity is a benefit from the moderation and reasonableness. If you have 100 pesos a day and you spend only 80 pesos, so you can save 20 pesos. This is, and you need a reasonable why you have to save money. And it becomes self-immunity because you have saving money during the emergency case. This is the dreams of the philosophy.
And so what activities do you undertake to encourage self-moderation and self-immunity?
In the community, the dishwashing detergent making, this one is the one project that we can reduce the money. Instead of buying the dishwashing detergent, we can produce it, so we can save money.
Okay.